Ah, amore. It is an Italian word and in English means love. E invincible. As a human being, we think to be invincible. D. Dreams. We love to dream all the time about an amazing future. S. Success. We all want to have a success in our life. Ides. Today is the 3rd December and it's the Ides Awareness Day. I made a clear decision. I wanted to change this world in something beautiful. Hi, I'm Fabio De Sio and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today my topic is AIDS. And we have to talk about that. Let me tell you first of all some numbers about this awful illness that unfortunately doesn't mean what I just say for you. It means acquired immune deficiency system. Last year, in 2019, 42 million people were living with HIV, that is really different than AIDS. I'm going to tell you the difference. 700,000 people died from AIDS. 42 million were living with HIV because AIDS is at the last stage of the HIV, that is the real illness, when you have a problem with your immune system, when the illness starts. 700,000 people, as I just said, died of AIDS, and 35 million people have been treated with the drugs. Because today we have a lot of drugs that can help this illness. Of course, today is completely different than 30 years ago when the illness arrived. In 1983, a star was born. Me! Now all of you know my age. But it was the year where this illness was arrived. Was given a name, HIV. Because in 1982, this illness was called greed, because it was only related to the gay men. In fact, what I'm going to talk about today, especially, is about how my community, the LGBTQ people, have been affected by this illness, not only for the health, but especially for the stigma around this illness. One of my favorite icons, it's Freddie Mercury. I really love him. And in the 80s, we all know the 80s were amazing because people were dancing all the time, there was a lot of party, there were the Studio 54, Andy Warhol was there, Joan Collins was there, all the amazing people. I wish I was there too, but probably I would be dead today. But in the same years, Freddie Mercury made in the world, he sang one of my favorite songs called I Want to Break Free. I Want to Break Free. I Want to Break Free. I love so much Freddie. And he was wearing a wig, a skirt. It was so controversial. The reason probably because I like him is because I'm controversial too as a life coach. I'm a controversial speaker. So this is the reason they probably connect all both of us. But Freddie couldn't tell that he in 1984 got this virus, the HIV virus. And only 1 month before he died, he could tell to the world that he was dying of AIDS. And he was the man that he was singing, I Want to Break Free, in the 1986. Why he couldn't be free? Because it was a stigma. And he said that he wanted to protect the people around him, especially his family, his boyfriend, all people around him. So for that reason, he couldn't say that he had HIV and after AIDS. There is a stigma is about ignorance, when people don't know. In fact, when the illness started, people were thinking that it could be contagious with everything, with the kiss, with the hug, with everything, like Especially now with the COVID-19, we can see how is we still don't know the how we can be contagious, but it's different, of course, because that illness, the HIV illness, was correlated to sex. We all know that when we talk about sex, there are a lot of issues around that, especially religious issues. We cannot talk about that, especially from a guy who came from a Catholic background. It's bad to talk about that as well. If you think about if we are right now, all of you that are watching me, we are because our parents one day made a decision to have fun or to make love, to have sex. That's all. It's not that problem. And especially in my community, we love sex a lot. So we used to have a lot of sex in the 1980s, especially my community got a lot of this illness. And many, many, many gay men died. But for people from the LGBTQ were really, how can I say, were dying, were discriminated. Everything awful happened to them. So I feel really hurt when I talk about them because I could imagine the pain that they were having. And now I'm going to tell you a story, a personal story about this because I have a lot of friends with HIV. And one friend that I will call Peter, when I was 25, I was living in Milan and he came to my house. I was a really different person than today. Probably you wouldn't like me. I don't know if you like me right now, but at the time you would hate me probably. And because I was living only surface life, I was thinking all about stuff. My life I could call sex, drugs, and rock and roll. And I will talk about that. How I was in pain in that period of my life. But all people were thinking that my life was amazing. But this friend came to my house with a bottle of champagne, a crystal, really expensive, and the cocaine because at the time I was using drugs to make me feel good. But when he came, I could see that he was different. And I said, "Peter, what's going on with you? Come on, tell me." And he started crying, crying, and he said, "Fabio, I have HIV. And I know that now you will never talk with me anymore." You can imagine a friend was thinking that that I wouldn't talk with him for this illness. And what I said, "Peter, I will be with you, and no matter what, if you need anything, I am there." In that moment, I understood that as well, if I was this kind of queen, there was my heart that I would say was black. In that moment, there was a little hope because I didn't use sympathy, but I used empathy. Because there's a huge difference of sympathy and empathy. Because sympathy is, "Oh, I'm sorry about that." Sympathy is, sorry for the word, shit. Empathy is, "Okay, I am with you, let's do something. And no matter what, I will be, we can do something." And after that, you know what I said? I said, "Come on, Peter, let's celebrate. We have champagne, cocaine, we are fabulous. Let's have fun. We enjoyed the night and it was amazing." Why I'm telling you the story? Because you shouldn't, stigma is a big thing. Because stigma most of the time is correlated with ignorance. If you don't know about this illness, you think, "Oh my God, please do research." And these days, really good to talk about with your friends, with your family, with all the people that you want. You can talk about this day. Another thing, you can contact many organizations for AIDS. You can donate some money for the research. And as well, for that point, I would like to tell you only one number, the last number that from 2000 until 2018, the San Francisco University, they said that they have been spent 500 billion for this illness. Let me tell you only one number. In the UK, only for coronavirus COVID test, they spent 12 billion. I think until now, I don't know how much money have been spent for coronavirus. And I know that it's an awful illness, but of AIDS, 33 million people died of AIDS. So I think we should do more and we should find a solution. But let me go back to how you can protect it from HIV. First of all, you can use a condom that are always good. Secondly, there is this therapy called PrEP. It's a pill that you have to take for 15 days if you have sex with someone who is positive, and you will not get the virus. Now, I'm going to finish asking you one favor, to dedicate 10 seconds to all people that died of AIDS. So let's do this 10 seconds together, and I will do the countdown. Please do it from now. I hope that all of you have done this 10 seconds because it's really important. And I would like to finish this talk showing my hands, because this hands means all the blood of the people that died of AIDS. And as well, if we didn't do anything, we have been part of that. And I feel that I didn't do a lot for them. So, hope that you enjoyed my talk about AIDS, and I will wait you for my next talk. Bye, remember, the 1st December, it's the AIDS Awareness, and let's talk about that.